Again, guys, sorry about that. My son came in guns blazing and he had to stop just for a second. And he said he calls the Kalila the sea whiskey. And he said, "Dad, why, how can you do a review and talk about the sea whiskey without your boat?" So now I have a boat. Anyway, where was I? I was torn between giving it 88 and 89 out of 100. Pushed it a little towards 89 out of 100 because I think that they're not actually giving Kalila the credit it deserves. And it's a beautiful distillery, characterful. I love it. Thank God it exists because I think it's the biggest one on Isla. It makes something like 6.5 million liters of pure alcohol per year. So, around 85% of that goes to blends, but without Kalila, there wouldn't be any Johnnie Walker. Maybe there would be, but it wouldn't taste as it tastes now. So beautiful character as this one. And I want to say a few other things about the nosing that I didn't mention before. Our sense of smell, as it's called, olfaction, is the only sense that doesn't get filtered by our cortex. Meaning, it is the only one that has direct access to the center of your brain. And I find it quite amazing, actually. One of my favorite things about it is that it is connected to your long-term memory and can trigger memories from more than 20 years ago. When this happens to you or to someone sitting next to you, if you're drinking with a buddy that you grew up with and he's explaining to you about how this smells like the cake that your grandmother used to make when you were in second grade. If he describes how it looks, you're not going to be able to recollect that memory. If he described how it tasted, it wouldn't work. But if you put your nose in the glass, it will take you right back then. You will travel in time and space into the second grade, and you will find yourself sitting on the table in your grandmother's house. So this is actually pretty amazing. And what I'm trying here to say is that you need to kind of appreciate things more. Meaning, if you never went to the marina, you never been in the sea, how are you supposed to know how the tarry ropes smell, the sails, the waves crashing so intensely that you can taste them in your mouth, you can taste the sea. And well, if you've never been there, how exactly is that gonna happen? I mean, how are you supposed to appreciate the Isle of Whiskies on that level? You don't want to be the guy that says, drinking something that is superb and someone asks you, "What you think about it?" And you say, "It's nice." No, it's not supposed to be nice. It's supposed to be incredible, unbelievable. The complexity that they carry is just out of this world. And something else that I wanted to share is that your nasal cavity is by nature anatomically asymmetrical, meaning, you know how always one of your nostrils works better than the other? Well, there's a reason for that. It's not because, you know, 17 years ago you got hit by football. No, that's the way we are built. And on another level, your brain can actually put on hold the chemical structures that you take in from one of your nostrils so that it can process the first one, then the second one. A lot of people don't know that actually they are responsible for different parts of your brain, the right one, the right, and so on. What that means is that you are able to find different things. That's why the nosing works like this. You have your mouth slightly open, you breathe, you see what you can find, the left one, the right one, together, and just whatever time you spend nosing, at least double that or triple it. No idea, but it's something really important, and I think at least 75% of the experience is there. So take your time. There are mouths that really need to breathe, really need time to settle. And once you find your rhythm, just things happen naturally. Pretty much, I think that's it. That's what I wanted to share. So, thanks for watching. Give me a thumbs up if you like it. Don't forget to subscribe. And that's the way the cookie crumbles. Thanks, guys.